Hello everyone, today we will discuss question number 6. But before starting with this, I want to rectify a statement of previous question number 5. In previous question, I told you that the final formed RSM is an equilateral triangle, but actually it is an isosceles triangle because RS and SM are equal and each measures 6 meters. So it was not an equilateral but an isosceles triangle. Now let's move to question number 6. It states that a circular path of radius 20 meters is situated in a colony. Three boys, Ankur, Sayyad and David, are sitting at equal distances on its boundary, each having a toy telephone in his hands to talk to each other. For all this, we have to find the length of the string of each phone. So let's figure out this statement. We are given a circular path C with center at O and radius 20 meters. And let the position of Ankur, Sayyad and David be denoted by capital A for Ankur, S for Sayyad and D for David. And these three positions we have located at equal distances along the boundary of circular path. And that's the center O of circle. Let's join A, S and D. So these are the length of strings of toy telephone used by each one. So this AS, SD and DA we have to calculate here. And remember that as Ankur, Sayyad and David are seated at equal distances along the boundary of circular path, so this triangle ASD would be an equilateral triangle in which AS, SD and AD are equal to each other. For all this we have to find AS, SD and AD, and all three are equal. So let's check how this could be determined. In order to determine this length, we consider this AS, SD and AD as equals to A unit each. So let this AS, SD and AD as equals to A unit each. And here we draw a perpendicular from A onto the opposite side SD. And in case of an equilateral triangle, this perpendicular would bisect the opposite side at M. And as this is a perpendicular bisector of the chord SD, so obviously it would be passing through the center of circle as well. Now we join center O2 S and D. And here you could observe that triangle OAS, OSD and ODA, these three are congruent to each other due to side and side. So due to triple S rule, all three triangles are found congruent to each other. That's why their area would be equal to each other. So we could equate this area of equilateral triangle ASD as equals to 3 times of the area of any one of these three congruent triangles. So here the area of equilateral triangle ASD is equal to 3 times the area of triangle OSD. Where this area of equilateral triangle ASD, we could calculate it using formula root 3 upon 4 into side square, and this side we considered earlier as A, so it is root 3 upon 4 A square. This equals to 3 into area of triangle OSD. This we could calculate using half into basis SD, and this measures A into height. This height is OM. Let's check the value of OM, and this OM is where OM height equals to AN minus AO. AN minus AO, and this AN we calculate from right triangle AMS using Pythagoras theorem. Let this be equation first, and now we try to calculate this AM. So in triangle AMS, using Pythagoras theorem, this AS square, which is A unit. So this A square equals to SM square. This SM is half of SD. It means A by 2. A by 2 square plus AM square. So this AM square equals to A square, and this on other side becomes minus A square upon 4, and on simplification this AM square becomes 4A square minus A square, 3A square upon 4, so that AM is root of 3A square upon 4. And this results to A upon 2 root 3, or root 3 A upon 2. Therefore, this OM equals to AM. This AM is root 3 upon 2 into A minus AO. AO is radius of the path, and that radius we are given 20 meter. So it is minus 20. Let's use this value of OM in equation first. So we use it in equation first. So we get this root 3 upon 4 into A square equals to 3 a upon 2 into om, and om is root 3 a upon 2 minus 20. Let's simplify this. So this reduces 1 power of a square, and 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So this is root 3 a upon 2 on other side, it is 3 times of 22s are 40, so it is root 3a minus 40 upon 2. These two are cancelled. Let's simplify this. It is root 3a equals to 3 root 3a minus 40, these are 120. Let's separate the terms containing a. So it is 3 root 3a minus root 3a equals to plus 120. Here a root 3a is common, or 3 root 3a minus root 3a. It is 2 root 3a. 2 root 3a. This equals to 120. So that a equals to 120 upon 2 root 3. Let's rationalize the denominator, for which both numerator and denominator are multiplied by root 3. So it is 120 root 3 upon root 3 into root 3. It is 3, 3 twos are 6. And 120 divided by 6 is 20. So that a becomes 20 root 3. And yes, that a we have to calculate here. So finally, we could declare that first, the length of the string used, length of the string used, equals to 20 root 3 meter. That's the requirement.